spray. The star shoots stakes. Here's the field. Number one, Beautiful Empire for John Oxley, Mark Cassie, and Emma Jane Wilson. Number two is Diabolic, also trained by Mark Cassie, owned by DJ Stable, LLC and Nexus Racing Club. The rider is Antonio Gallardo. Three, Miss Alacrity for CJ Thoroughbreds, Wesley Ward, and Kazushi Kimura. Four is Aubrietta, Manfred and Penny Conrad owners, Mark Cassie trainer, and jockey Patrick Husbands. Burton C. Jones, owner of five, Parlance, trained by Steve Asmussen with jockey Rafael Hernandez. And to number six, How Do You Make Your Money? Mike Trombetta, training for Commonwealth New Era Racing. In the saddle, Justin Stein, and this is the feature today, the Starshoot Stakes, race 8, 6 minutes away.
The pick of the paddock for me, How Do You Make Your Money, makes a great pre-race appearance here today. I'm going to take a shot with Aubrietta. She impressed me a great deal in the Glorious Song last season. I just hope that it was the two turns that got her last campaign, and that's the direction I'm going to go towards. And she's just a better price right now than Diabolic. I think Diabolic might actually be the better of the two. Was obviously a Sovereign Award finalist last season and had a great campaign, as a matter of fact, to wrap up the year with a bit of a disappointing effort in the Talmud, but can definitely bounce back. And Mark Cassie mentioned to me that he was really happy with how Diabolic was training coming into this race. The newcomer this season is How Do You Make Your Money. Hasn't run yet at Woodbine so far this season, but has run. And with more information on how the horse is coming into this race, we caught up with Mike Trombetta's assistant trainer here at Woodbine, Darren Glennon, to find out more about How Do You Make Your Money is doing coming into today's events.
Here with Darren Glennon, sub-trainer from Mike Trombetta. How Do You Make Your Money, Darren? Talk about this filly.
Three-year-old filly, you know, she's had two races over the wintertime. Ran a pretty decent race the last time. Got beat about seven lengths to what looks to be a pretty substantial runner. Comes back here now. She was here last year for the Glorious Song, of course. She ran second, ran extremely well, and now for this race coming back, she gets back on the Lasix program.
How important is that for her to get back on that?
Well, I mean, obviously her best race was run with the Lasix, so you know, you'd like to get back in the situation to give yourself the very best shot. She gets it here. She gets an outside post position. She gets a small field. And Mike said she's in tip-top shape. She really woke up coming into this race, and she's got off the van in great shape. She was pretty sharp this morning, and she looks happy.
This is going to be interesting.
I cannot wait to see how this is going to go. We're going to have to sit here and watch this before we start this up. $10, please. $4.20 for last race for the number six horse. That would have been funny. We got some interesting ones in this field, that's for sure. Well, there's five and three. We just need the four and the one to get up.
Beautiful Empire, the trio for the Mark Cassie barn at the back of affairs. Miss Alacrity on the inside, Pylon's the udder. A couple away now, Diabolic fighting stride on the inside of How Do You Make Your Money. They're in pairs. Aubrietta the outside of Beautiful Empire. Still neck and neck up front. Miss Alacrity on the inside, Pylon's the udder as they go inside the 5/16. Diabolic looking for room as a length and a half behind. Beautiful Empire finishing up the rail. Diabolic coming now as they turn. And it is Pylon's in front of Miss Alacrity. Joining us, Diabolic down the
come
center.
Come on, come on, four.
Empire,
room up
the inside, track.
Oh my, oh my.
Well.
No, the five. Oh, you bastard.
Beautiful Empire right through on the inside. And Beautiful Empire takes the shortcut to victory in the running of the Starshoot Stakes.
Oh, so close.
Has run 1, 2, 3 in the order of Beautiful Empire, Aubrietta, Diabolic, and then came How Do You Make Your Money, Pylon's at last, Miss Alacrity, 1.870.
That was good.
Second, Aubrietta. Third has gone to two, Diabolic. Commonwealth was 6. How do you make your money? Numbers are 1, 4, 2, 6.
That was close. That was close. See what the payouts are here. I mean, 3-1 in second, 2-1 in third, and then 7-2. It's not too bad. That was nice.
Beautiful empire. Visually impressive last win, and even more so today. It's a stakes victory for the chestnut 3-year-old filly, who's a 2-time winner this season at Woodbine back-to-back. And congrats to Mark Cassie, who trained first, second, and third place finishes in the race. John Oxley is the owner of the filly, a 3-year-old chestnut by Classic Empire from Humor Me Colonel. Springhouse Farm bred the winner in Kentucky, and Emma Jane Wilson with a nice winning ride takes a double hit today as Beautiful Empire is the winner of the Starshoot Stakes.
I kind of want to learn. Back to the game here. Let's see this. This is something that I wanted to show because I was looking at this last time off stream was the challenges. This is pretty interesting, I gotta say. I mean, I don't really know. I find it so funny that they have this. They have a lot of time limit challenges in this, which is not too bad. This one's a fuel limit. Okay. Time limit. Stripe challenge. So I kind of want to learn how to do the stripes. Hopefully I might have to see, because they got two stripe challenges here. Fuel limit. I can do this one, which is pretty interesting. And then they got the gold one. Stripe challenge, fuel limit, stripe, time limit, fuel, stripe challenge. That, like, the stripe challenges is pretty interesting, because I gotta see. Yeah, that's gonna be interesting. But anyways, let's get back to the career. Alright, we wanna see how much these things cost. Oh, good lord. This is interesting. You know that? that's a pretty nice one. 26,000 euros. Wow. 31. Holy Jesus. Look at this thing. My only question is, can you... Like, that's the Kingsbury House. That's what they have. Okay. Confirm. Employee. Now, I don't know exactly if you get to sign people up, because I am new to this. So, yeah. I don't really know if you get to... This is gonna be nice. So let's see how the sound tests out here. It's kind of nice. Oh, that's a lot better. I'm not gonna lie. So you have 30 minutes to complete this. This is gonna be fun. Okay. Ground check. All right. How do I sprint again? Oh, okay. Oh, there's one. Come here. I gotta look for dog shit on the ground, too, don't I? Oh my god. How many do I need to find? Five. Oh my god, this is gonna be brutal. Brutal. Anyone? Where the fuck is this stuff here? Oh dear. There's a gnome. I see you. There's three. What else do we have here? What's going to be around here now? Okay, I gotta check. Down to 2 minutes. I'm kind of bad at this here. Here. Oh man, this is brutal. Come on. Okay, so there's two more items around here. What could it possibly be? Oh. One more item. Maybe it might be around here? My best guess? No? Okay. What about here? Five objects around here. Oh. Something? No? Okay. Dude, where the hell is this thing? Where the hell is this thing? Uh-oh. We're gonna run out of time here pretty soon. I mean, I'm not seeing anything that resembles something to pick up here. Oh, there it is. Gotcha, bitch. There we go. Nice job. Okay. What do you think? Should we change the cutting blades, or... I mean, should I refuel? Fuel fuel? I mean, that would be a given, right? Like, you don't want to run out of fuel. I mean, it does only cost $1.87. So, I mean, like, yeah, fuck. Why not? There we go. No, not you. Now, I have seen in some cases where people have used the trimmer to start off and they just walk along the edges. I mean, that would be a pretty good idea. But maybe we'll just have at it and then go and clean up afterwards. We do got 30 minutes, which is not that bad. But again, this is a pretty big area. And, like, I mean, like, where should you start? Do I start over here? Or do I leave this for last? I would say the smart thing is to pound out this, right? Or do we just go... Or do we start here and go around? You can survey this stuff. This is pretty fun. Go along the edges and just do like a big circle wrapping around, or should we just go up and down? Like, say, like, start off here, go up, go down, and then that way we take care of this area first, right? Some decisions before I get on this thing. Yeah, I'll be right back. All right, let's go. Flowers. That looks like okay though. I'm thinking we just get rid of. Oh, damn it. Should I loop around? Actually, you know what? Let's go this way. Let's give this a try out. Oh dear. I'm already having a horrible time at this. And yeah, this is kind of peaceful. That's okay, whatever. We might have made a mistake here a little bit, but we're avoiding the big stuff already here. Again, it's not that bad. I think the blade is fine for now, and we won't have to replace it until next time we do this. So yeah, just in case though. I mean, should have done that big circle, but we'll find out. We may have made a mistake or two today. welcome to One More Simulator, everyone. This is, you're watching this, you are watching a man cut grass. I mean, look, I think that we're making not bad time to use. I mean, we're not even at the halfway point. I thought that this was going to take a lot longer, to be honest with you. I keep on forgetting that I don't even have to go to... Well, I mean, not that I don't have to go to... Well, shit. Well, that's the reason why, probably. Yes, yes, yes. We're taking out flowers. I don't really care about flowers there, lady. Oh, crap. Nope. Wait, how do I... What? Do I have a garbage bag? Oh. I think that we're way ahead of schedule right now, but let's just go do this, and then we can go along. what's your trimmers for? I'm not going to worry about these edges too much because I can always go back and trim them if I need to. I mean, there's just a legit outline going here. You know what I mean? My fault on these flowers, but in the way, to be honest. I mean, we're more than halfway done, which is kind of nice. Oh, crap. Beep, 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 beep. Yeah. I mean, that's not so bad. Oh man, look at that. Okay, I could probably go back and take care of that in a second. Thank you. Can you imagine if I didn't find these things, what would have happened to them? Oh my goodness, Mongo would have been just right up here. Okay, I say at this point now. No, okay. Maybe. And it doesn't look like I messed too much on this side. There's a few spots right there that need to be covered up with this one. Oh shit. Jesus Christ. I care about your flowers, but with the other way now, so I mean, like, once we get through this, I say, the point in here, I say we just go around, over it, so let's not. See, I'm smart, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. completely just cut it off right there. Look at that there, right? That's beautiful. I think I can probably go back there. That looks pretty good. All right. Okay. And then we're going to go back to the truck because we're at 25. I think we've got like the GS about everything. So yeah, Oh. Whoa. God damn it. Oh well. Can't be perfect every single time. There we go. I think I did this one pretty well. I'm thinking that that's it, unless if I, good job. May have suffered penalties, but whatever. Yeah, might as well. You know what? Blades is okay, I think, for now. Alright. I mean, I think that that's pretty good. But I think I did a pretty horrible job, but whatever. I think I'm going to suffer penalties, though, because I took flowers. Oops. My bad. Okay, confirmed. Whatever. 330. Not bad, not bad. I mean, that's good. Right, two. There we go. Okay. HQ. Okay. Here you can edit your avatar or company ID as well as take out advertisements to gain more RP reputation points toward ranking up your company's current rank and progress bar to the next rank you need. See right there on the top right. Okay. Upgrading your company HQ. Currently your HQ has only one vehicle bay, but once you earn more money, you can upgrade it to have a second vehicle bay, or purchase a bigger HQ with multiple extra vehicle bays. Interesting. That would be something to look at. Once you have a second vehicle, you can start to hire another employee to complete extra contracts and earn more money in RP. Okay, that sounds pretty good. We're always in the business for hiring people. Insufficient funds. Oh, wait. Oh. Purchase headquarters. Do I gotta purchase one? Or do I gotta company advertisement? Okay. So, I can do a social media ad, local flyers, printed ads. That's interesting. Okay. I mean, that's pretty good. I mean, I could do a social media ad. Maybe, or do I go for broke and, I mean, I do have 900 bucks. I mean, that's pretty cool. Or you can go back, edit player. What the hell is this one now? Oh, that's nice. Nice one. Rebuilding. Ooh, nice. Ooh, unlimited bay available. How much is that? 200,000. Wow. Huh. Interesting. Okay. What's this? Active loan. Well. Huh. The loans. Apply for a loan. Oh. Oh, that's pretty cool. I don't really have any loans, but okay. I'll be right back. Well, we got some contracts here to go through, and this is going to be interesting for next episode, as I was just talking with the mic muted on here. I will see everyone next episode, and have yourselves a wonderful weekend. Lucy, I love you. You're amazing. And take care, everyone. Bye.